Umdangasi FM, the sound of the city.
It is the month of love. We love love. We love to celebrate love. But more importantly, as funa ukuthi abantu basale ngiyangena yothando. So ebethi bayavuka bavuka nezinye izinto abangayiplenanga. So today we're talking teenage pregnancy. One in three girls has had a baby at the age of 20. Usho kanjalo David Harrison, the chief executive officer of Love Life. Also KZN's khulumile ukuthi it has the highest teenage pregnancy rate as of 2013. These were the stats. More than 26,000 recorded, followed by Eastern Cape with more than 20,000. And just the biggest thing, what do you think ngabe isixazululo se teenage pregnancy mhlambe ungabe wena ucabanga lapha ekhaya? But we're going to cross over to Mangosuthu University of Technology. Ngiyazi ukuthi namhlanje kukhona o Sister Nomusa Mkhwanazi, who's from the clinic lapha eMangosuthu. Ngiyazi abalekelela ama students who want to test for HIV. There's also sexual education that's happening, and we're going to just cross over to her ukuzwa possibly some of the offerings that the clinic has ukusiza abantu abasha. Sawubona Sister Nomusa, and welcome ohlelweni.
Sawubona Msakazi.
Ehhe, ngifisa ukubuza la ukuthi ngiyazi ukuthi enyuvesi ngithi kune clinic, mhlawumbe iziphi insiza ezikhona for abafundi
kule clinic lase Mangosuthu? Sinama services aqala ngeprimary health care.
Mhm.
Where sibona ama students mayegula into encane njengoflu, headache, diarrhea, lezo zinto ezinjalo, bese siyawa treater, siwa educate at the same time ukuthi bak prevent kanjani izifo. Bese siba ne program, HIV AIDS program. I program yethu sino partner or sponsor u HOD, who also give us funding. The university inayo e funding iyo urana le program. Kule program encourage ama students ukuthi atheste to know their HIV status.
Yes, yeah.
Kule program sine peer education where sicela ama students a volunteer bese siwafundisa ukuthi abe ama peer educator. Bese ama peer educator bese fundisa amanye ama students abaqashise ngegciwane lesandulela ngculazi nengculazi.
Sister,
kule program siphinde sibe distribute ama condom because ama condom ayasiza ukuthi abantu abangatheleleki ngegciwane lesandulela ngculazi. So a distributor esikoleni, campusini, clinic, bese siphinde siwa distribute nasema residences ukuthi ama students angawasweli ama condom ukuze mayifuna ukwenza ucansi aphephe.
Sister Mkhwanazi, ngiyabona uyawabala wonke lama services, but ngokubona kwakho ama students ayeza yini ukwasebenzisa ukusebenzisa insiza ezikhona within a campusini?
Yes, ama students ayawa access ama services esiwanikezayo. Ngoba ngaphandle kwe-HIV and AIDS sibuye sibe ne-family planning. Sisebenzisana no-Department of Health, uyasipha ama-treatment, uyasipha amaphilisi, umjovo yokuvimbela ukukhulela. So ama-students aye-accessa naleyo service. Siphinde basize futhi ukuthi ba-teste, ba-check-e i-status sabo se-pregnancy. Bese-ke sibarefere ema-clinic la bezohamba khona i-antenatal clinic. Bese sibuye futhi sibazisa nge-termination of pregnancy. Asiyipromoti kodwa i-right yawo ama-students ukuthi azi ukuthi ikhona i-option ye-termination of pregnancy. If wouldn't be futhi kuyisebenzisa, bese sibarefere kune-student counseling esisebenzisana naso ukuze bayolungiseleka kahle ngokomqondo. Bathi uma beyithatha le service bangabi nama-issues later in life.
Yeah.
Sibuye sisebenzisana center. Uyafika njalo eclinic ngolesibili njoba nje kukhona lo mcimbi nawo ukhona namhlanje. Utshela ama students ngale service ye termination of pregnancy namanye ama services because bakhuluma nango family planning, bakhuluma ngo HIV testing, akubona nje ukukhiphi izizo kuphela.
Wow, sibonge kakhulu Sister Nomusa Mkhwanazi. Mhlawumbe ngokubona kwakho iexperience yakho ama students mayefika ezothola usizo, kubaluleke kangakanani ukuthi umuntu azi ngalama services ukuze asizakale?
Siqala nje ama students mayefika first years ngesikhathi befika kwenziwa iorientation. Iclinic nalo liba yipart of that orientation kanye nawo wonke ama department. So siyaba bazisa abafundi ukuthi ilama services akhona. Family planning, sikhitha ama STI, family planning unaloku njengezinto ezinjengo morning after pill mabe futhi kuyithatha sihlale sinasi stock sayo nasi futhi so ama students they are made away if you are
doing this yes
yes una ma services nje atshelwe nekhathi ukuthi clinic lisebenza ngekhathi ethile liba khona bese bawa access ama services as and when they wafuna.
Wow. Thank you so much, Sister Nomusa Mkhwanazi. Sikhuluma naye, she is live at the Mangosuthu University of Technology. Ukhona ke no MEC uDokotela uDlomo. We're going to try to also chat to him, see nje mhlamba ama strategies akhona kwa health to uku decrease la stats of teenage pregnancy. But sesizwile ukuthi in the institutions of higher learning, there are services that students can use to empower themselves, to our knowledge is power, and that's the first step in preventing izinto ongafisi zenzeke empilweni yakho.
FM, the sound of the city.
So we are joined by the MEC, uDokotela Dhlomo. Sawubona.
Sawubona. Ngangana nomkhuba nomanti la ngimanga ngithatha ukuthi manje ngalika kasi. Sawubona
ke. Ukhuluma nomamzolo ba.
Omamzolo.
Yes.
Siyabongelela sibingelela abalazi lekagasi FM.
Baba, one of the things that stands out, ukuthi the stats keep on, you know, growing, and we're trying to get them ukuthi zibe ncane. Mhlambe, what are the possible strategies esingawabheka no health owabhekayo to curb the rise of teenage pregnancy?
Is the excitement that one is finding here at Mangosuthu University of Technology, which we think is going to have an impact going forward. It's exciting to know that they have actually maintained this tradition of keeping their university alcohol free. Now, this is not a force, it is a choice that the student leadership and all students have made. And I think you'll agree with me, Uguti, people who drink, probably even get drunk, sometimes they make mistakes like waking up in a bed that they never planned to wake up from.
Wow,
and therefore, one can attest and say it is unlikely that there is a student in this university who would find himself or herself waking up in a wrong bed because they were actually not sober. And really want to think we must commend the students and say we hail them for this tradition and wish that they could rub it on to other students in other campuses. That I thought it was important to highlight that as a first point. But secondly, one is coming down to encourage students to focus on this program, to say you have done well up to where you are now at the university. We need to therefore accelerate a program that supports you on what we call first things first. Meaning that what did you come to Mangosuthu University of Technology for? It was for a diploma or a degree. Why don't you then focus and concentrate on that and therefore allow all other programs to support your vision? Because it's such a huge investment that the country has made on you to now. You just left with a couple of years so that that final product, which is yourself, comes out. Therefore, we are here, among other things, to encourage them. Because most of these ones are now beyond the age of being teens. They are just 18, 19. So the actual teenager program, these students have really jumped it. Some of them probably had, but they are now. I'm glad because the issue of teenage pregnancy is such that not many students who get to be pregnant during their teenage life ever get a chance to come back to a university or to continue their studies.
That's very true.
When they get pregnant at the age of 16 and the age of 18, instead of going back to school, they fall pregnant again. At the age of 22, they are already breastfeeding a baby number 3. Now, this is something we need to come and highlight to these students and say to them, we have done well up to now. You only have got 3 or 4 years in your life to complete and come out and be a good product.
Wow. I know MEC, Dr. Dhlomo, you've mentioned one of the triggers, alcohol, but has reached such established as izinto ezilidela umuntu omusha ukuthi agcine eyibone esekhulelwe encane.
The other pressures that come in is probably issues related to poverty, where we are going to be pleading with the young girls in particular to say your poverty in your household should not actually predispose you to this campaign that we have pushed in the province of sugar daddies.
Oh, yes, yes.
We want honest and decent men who would say, yes, there's poverty around the area where I live. I'll assist one or two students, but in return, I'm not going to ask them to use their bodies to satisfy me.
Wow. Yeah.
Because there's always going to be people who are not as fortunate as yourself in around you. But if you were to assist them and therefore say in return for assisting them, they must then have sexual favors, then that is wrong. In most cases, these sugar daddies sometimes have got their own established families. They are actually using these young girls out of lust, not because of love. So we are also going to be talking very strongly on that campaign. Yeah. But however, the other thing that we are going to be raising with the students is related to equal protection.
All right, yes.
To say if you are therefore unable to take this message that we are going to push forward, to say please delay sexual activity as much as you can. If they can't delay it, we therefore say to them, why don't you then engage yourself into a practice that allows you to be both as a girl on a condom and also on a family planning program?
Yes.
Because if you do that, you delay falling into pregnancy, you delay pregnancy, you delay, you don't even get sexually transmitted infections and HIV. For young men, we ask them to also condomize together with circumcision, because we say circumcision alone is not a complete 100% cover.
Yes,
so the combination of those, that's why we call it a dual protection. You do both.
Yes.
Therefore, we guarantee you that you are unlikely to make anybody pregnant or fall pregnant if you are on this program.
Yes.
You are unlikely to get a sexually transmitted infection. You are also unlikely to get an HIV. So when we push this campaign, therefore, we hope that students are going to take this message forward and assist themselves and other fellow students.
Of course, of course. And we have to hold our young men accountable as well. In closing, MEC, sicela ukubuza nje umbuzo ogcina ukuthi mhlambe ukusihighlightela the dangers of becoming pregnant mhlambe for umuntu that's below the age of 18 emzimbeni wakhe kwenzekalani.
We are guided by the recommendations coming in from the WHO, the World Health Organization, because they are studying and observing people all over the world to say any girl who falls pregnant at the age of 18 and younger is likely to actually experience a lot of problems. In fact, in South Africa, let me just give you the statistics. The teenage pregnancy in our country is accounts for 8% of all the people who are falling pregnant. So if you've got a million South Africans who are going to be falling pregnant in a year, 80,000 of those
are young people,
are teenagers.
Yeah.
But when you therefore translate that 80,000, accounts for 25% of mothers who die on a pregnancy-related outcome. So that 8% of teenage pregnancy gives you a big number of women who die during pregnancy because, one, their bodies are not matured enough that they can carry a baby. Sometimes they actually are facing these complications of being pregnant too young at the age of 15. They get eclampsia and all other diseases. Number three, they fail to push a baby because their bodies are still too small.
Wow.
And therefore, we have to actually rely on doing major operations on them. And some of them don't survive on these major operations. So, and others, they delay and hide that they are pregnant. By the time they come in, it's too late. And we have not even done any health assessment of themselves and the baby. So there's a huge crisis. In fact, to put it in one sentence, teenage pregnancy is a risky pregnancy. Just rather avoid it.
Wow. Wow. Thank you so much. Powerful words there by the KZN MEC, Dr. S. Dhlomo. Siyabonga kakhulu, Baba, for your time. And I do hope the message the teenagers can take and begin to live. Ukuthi siqale sehlise teenage pregnancy. Thank you so much.
But thank you too, because without you, we will not be having this opportunity to spread the message to abantu bonke. And thanks for Ikagas for the support. And we hope that we are going to continue supporting us and work with you as partners. Siyabonga.
Of course, siyabonga kakhulu baba. Gagasi
FM, the sound of the city. Just the first question, as the president of Students SRC, what do you do to ensure ukuthi ama health facilities? Obviously, I'm a student. I totally access CIO as the president.
Okay. Firstly, in our institution, we've got peer helpers and peer educators. Those structures, those students were established to ensure that we assist our students in different residences, because we've got external residences where other students they reside on. We've got programs like Your Graduate Alive campaign, which is led by a student political structure called South African Student Congress that has deployed me to be where I am today. That campaign is assisting in ensuring that students are well aware of what is expected from them in terms of their health. And also in the SRC side, we've got an officer called Health and Welfare Officer. I'm sure we've seen the lady called Bongi Mzolo. She's dealing with these programs and she was part and parcel of this arrangement of this auspicious program to ensure that we make students aware that it's very important for them to be alive and to be safe and to be healthy. Yeah.
Just a second question. Obviously, maningi amarez ahlukahlukene aqaqene and all that stuff. How do you ensure ukuthi lama services filter into within the different races and obviously ukuthi asebenze at the same time?
Okay. One of the good things that we're having is that we've got a clinic service here. And obviously, in our residence, we've got what we call substructures of the SRC house committees. And these peer helpers and peer educators, they reside there in those residences. So we've got one of them is responsible of ensuring that these healthy activities are done in their different residences, and also the likes of condoms, where students embark on the sexual programs and so forth. They know that this is part of their safety and so forth in our residences. Yeah.
In closing, mhlambe kukhona ongafuna ukusho kwama students, obviously to ensure ukuthi lama services lawa they get utilized in the proper manner and adjusted ukubanika some kind of awareness that can assist them.
Yeah, what I can say is that our students, luckily they listen to us, and when they listen to us, we always give proper guidance to them and we will encourage them whenever they've got problems that speaks of their health and so forth. They know the SRC office, they know the clinic service, they know their peer helpers and house committees and so forth. They must make use of them. And the good thing is that our institution is an alcohol-free institution. So somehow it assists us a lot that our students, they are warned and they are aware of the abuse of alcohol, and they don't embark on that one within the institution. We don't know outside, but we always encourage them not to participate in such activities. Thank you.
The FM, the sound of the city.